Yet another obstacle. You've crossed the wrong mark.
I'll cut you wide open.
My son, I will see to your demise. Marched me to the bones today.
As it should be.
My not so numerous, but nonetheless dearest guests. About a year ago at my last birthday party, I assured you all that I nurtured a deep-seated hatred for boring people who give protracted speeches in the misplaced belief that their inner thoughts are of any interest to anyone but themselves. Now I am a whole year older, and also a full-fledged crusader, an honorable position that requires me to be as dull, pedantic, and vexing as I possibly can. Therefore, a speech it is. The revered cleric Nestrin, my guardian and tutor, often told me that those who live a sinful life may expect to join the abyssal hordes after they die. This is why their path is the most despicable of all. A part of their soul may return to Mendev in the abominable form of a demonic invader. Every time we see a demon, we might as well think about it. What if this wretched creature used to be your great-great-grandfather? What if certain parts of this pointy-tailed beauty used to belong to your pious cousin? They say that the demons represent the sins of the souls they are made of. Succubi emerge out of lustful souls. Vandals turn into Abracandilu. Gluttons become Nabasu. I, for one, am determined to commit as many different sins as possible, so that the distributive mechanism of the Abyss breaks when it tries to decide what to do with my soul. You, my dearest guests, will be my assistants in this complicated task. Eat, drink, and indulge yourselves in whatever vices you can. Let nobody leave this house as righteous as they entered it. Live every day like it's your last. After all, nobody knows when that day will arrive, do they?
That is not far.
Hey,
I'll go ahead. I know the way. Follow my lead. It is finished. As it should be. That is not far.
Thank you.
I'll go ahead. I know the way. Follow my lead.